Hello, welcome to MooMooMath. In this video, I'd like to demonstrate how to add and subtract integers. And in this video, I'm going to use chips to visually show how to add and subtract the integers. Obviously, I do not have chips. I have a nickel and a penny. And the nickel will represent the positive number because it's more positive to get 5 cents back as opposed to just a penny. And the penny will be negative. And also, let me introduce what's called a zero pair and a zero pair is when you have a positive and a negative and they cancel each other out. So it will represent a zero pair. So let's go ahead and get started. The first one, I have 4 plus a negative 3. So what I will do is I will set out 4 positive chips. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 3 negative chips. 1, 2, 3. And so this is where the zero pairs will come into play because, you know, a positive and a negative, they just cancel out. So the zero pair will cancel, zero pair will cancel, and this will cancel. And we are left with 1 positive chip. So that will equal 1. Okay. So let's go back and work a couple more examples. And I've got a couple twists for you. Next is negative 3 plus positive 4. So what I will do is I will place out 3 negatives, 1, 2, 3. And remember, it's more negative to get a penny as opposed to a nickel. And then I have 4 positives, 4 positives, 1, 2, 3, 4. My zero pairs cancel out. These cancel, these cancel, these cancel. I know I went a little fast. And we are left with 1 positive. So that will equal positive 1. Okay, now we have a little wrinkle here. We have 3 minus a negative 2. Okay, you can't put 3 positive down, okay, and then put 2 negative down because it just doesn't work that way. So what I like to do is just go ahead and convert it to an additional problem. So whenever I encounter a negative, I just rewrite it and I make this sign a positive and then change the sign of the number right beyond the negative sign. So the 2 would become a positive 2. So now I have an addition problem. I've switched the sign from negative to positive, and then I've changed the sign of the number directly behind that from negative to positive. So now I just set it up like I would normally. I have 3 positive, okay? I find that that's the easiest thing to do. Some people teach that you put in, for whenever you have minus a negative, you put in a zero pair, but I've just found that this is easy. Excuse me, I do not put negatives in. I put positive instead. So now I have, okay, I've put 3 positives on this side, 2 positives on the other, and I am left with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 positives. So that answer is positive 5. Okay, let's go ahead and work. Okay, let's go ahead and work the next one. This next one we have minus 4 and positive 3. So I will place 4 negatives. Remember, a penny is negative because it's worse than getting, you only get 1 penny back as opposed to 5. Okay. And then we add 3 positives. So we have 1, 2, 3. I can see that I have 3 zero pairs, so they will cancel. This pair cancels. This pair cancels. This pair cancels. And I am back left with 1 negative. So that would equal negative 1. And finally, we have one more subtraction problem. So let's go ahead and set this up. And you know, whenever we have subtraction, I'm going to move this up so you can see it. Whenever we have subtraction, before I begin, I just convert it to an addition problem. You'll get the same answer. So I change the subtraction to a negative to a positive, and then change the sign on the number directly behind the subtraction. And so that becomes a 4. Okay, so then I'll set it up. I'll put 5 positives, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 5, 4 more positives. Okay, 3, and I'm about to run out of nickels. And there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 positives. Notice we do not have 0 pairs, so they will not cancel. So that equals a positive 9. Okay, I hope that helps in figuring out how to add and subtract integers. Remember, MooMooMath uploads a new math video every day. If you enjoy this, please subscribe and share. Thank you.